Proud William Worth School community. This is Proud Principal Rhonda Simley, and I am so glad today is the day that I can show you some of the upgrades and changes we've made based upon the CDC and Prince George County Public Schools expectations around social distancing and hybrid learning. Let's take a tour. Upon arrival, all students and staff members, as well as visitors, must come in. We have signs located on the exterior doors that indicate you must have a mask in order to enter this building. You also must have your temperature check taken if you are a visitor to William Worth Middle School. Let's come inside and see. Upon arrival into the building, all visitors that have a scheduled appointment must have their temperature taken.
Body temperature 97.0.
After which, that information will be recorded by our security staff on our contact tracker sheet, right here. Afterwards, everyone must get a squirt of hand sanitizer. For those individuals that have appointments within the building, we have the sneeze guard barrier protectors that are up on the desk. And it is the expectation that any individual that enters the building with a mask on will stand behind the sneeze guard in order to have conversations with our amazing main office staff members. All right, I am proud to introduce to some of you and reintroduce to those who already know. This is our amazing building supervisor, Mr. Benny Howard. Mr. Benny Howard is going to talk about some of the steps he has gone through with his team in order to ensure that all students are safe and all classrooms are clean.
All right, welcome to William Worth Middle School. Benny Howard, building supervisor. New things that we're using that specialize with this COVID-19 thing is the new Mark II. Germicides and disinfector and all that above, so you might get a bottle of this. And we're also using Slam. This is a lemony smell, smells good, but it also is very effective with killing COVID-19. So Slam, and that's what we're using now, wipe down. And we're also using a germicider, which is a heat liquid, and we spray it throughout the room and it kills everything, even on your paperwork, posters, and whatever it is that they're using, student desks and everything. So that's what we're using now. Hi, another feature that we have with this COVID-19, the hand sanitizer. They're located all over the hallway, and some will even be placed in some classroom that doesn't have sinks. And we're doing our best to try to place these throughout the building wide. So that's another great step we're taking.
Another safety measure we put in place at William Worth Middle School is to have a bathroom cleaning schedule. Based upon the CDC as well as Prince George County guidelines, the bathrooms are to be cleaned at minimum 3 times a day. However, at William Worth, we have hourly cleaning beginning at 7:30 in the morning. We also purchased anti-fog face shields. Each teacher will receive a face shield for their use in their classrooms. As you can see, this is our cafeteria. We have desks that are socially distanced 6 feet apart, where this space will be utilized for staff members to come in to have lunch. All students will eat lunch in their classroom so we can limit mobility. Students will have a grab and go lunch option that will be delivered to classrooms, and staff personnel will be there to ensure that students eat their lunch in a safe and orderly manner, and also allow them some time to stretch, possibly go outside, walk around the school grounds, and just have a stretch break. All right, so this is one of our classrooms. As you can see, we have the desks set up to be 6 feet apart. As you also see, you have a sign on each desk where students will not sit. The student will sit right here. This desk will serve as a place to keep their belongings and their items, as far as their backpacks, if it's still cold weather, also have their books, and all that will go right here. The backpack can either go on the back of this chair or that chair, and their belongings can be placed inside the chair. You also see in each classroom, we have a PPE kit. The PPE kit contains Lysol wipes, a small hand sanitizer, a package of gloves, Kleenex, additional mask, and the Mark II cleaner that Mr. Howland spoke about earlier. Each teacher will have this. It will be replenished as needed. Also, each classroom has the foam hand sanitizing soap dispensers for those classrooms that have sinks, as well as the paper towel dispenser. For those classrooms, those outside classrooms that we have that do not have sinks, we have purchased gallon-sized hand sanitizers as well as Purell hand wipes that they will have access to, along with creating a hand washing schedule for those classes.
For the rooms that have more students, we'll be using this atomizer cleaner, and which will be coming in maybe twice a day. We're supposed to do it once a day, maybe two or three times a day as an additional cleaner. What I would do is start from the back of the room. And I would start from the back of the room and spray. You know, I spray desk, papers, and everything all the way out until the front door. These are door that keep the door ajar. Another wonderful gift that Principal Simley brought for her individual teachers that limit the touching of the door. What you do is just place this between the door and voila.
The door stopper is a great asset that allows the teacher to have students enter in the building while she is socially distanced and welcoming them into her wonderful, or his wonderful, environment. All right, so this is our health suite. As you can see, we have a sneeze guard at the nurse's desk. We also have our PPE products that have been coming in. And inside the nurse's suite, we have two rooms. This room on the left is where students will be allowed to come into the nurse's suite that have non-COVID-like symptoms. They will sit in here while the nurse does her triage. And on this side will be our care room. This is where students that have COVID-like symptoms will be placed. We are in the process of getting partitions to place between the three beds so they can be socially distanced as much as possible. All right, as you can see, this is our gymnasium, and in order to meet the guidelines that have been established by the CDC and Prince George's County with social distancing, due to the overcrowdedness of the school, we had to turn this into multiple classrooms. So as you can see, all desks have been set up to be 6 feet apart. There are corkboard partitions that will be used to keep classrooms separated, as well as to display any teaching artifacts and anchor charts that need to be put up. Teachers will have access to whiteboards that will be mobile, that can be moved throughout the different space in here, as well as access to the internet. We have had additional Wi-Fi drops placed in the gymnasium, and we also have put in a work order for live phone jacks in the gymnasium. As you can see from the decals that are on the floor, this is the exit for the exterior doors. The expectation is all students will come through these doors to leave at the end of the day. And this is our current dismissal process until updates have been communicated to schools. I want to thank you for coming on this tour with us. I hope we have met your expectations to ensure that your students, our scholars, are safe. Have a great day. See you soon.